Hi, I'm Rong Ji with Keysight Technologies, and in this video, I'm going to introduce you how to do wideband signal calibration using Keysight PathWave signal generation desktop software, advanced waveform utility application, or simply called PWSG AWU with Keysight signal analysis desktop software called PathWave VSA. You are probably all too familiar with issues caused by long connections. The longer the cable, the higher the loss. When you add components between the signal generator and the DUT, the calibration plane and the test plane are not the same plane. You must correct the difference between the two planes. The flatness correction can compensate the transmission loss and help achieve robust flatness performance as the input to your DUT. PWSG AWU desktop application provides an easy way to automate the correction filter file generation using PathWave VSA software in real time. The calibration is done by applying reversion of channel response from VSA to the waveform. Then the waveform applied with the correction filter file can be downloaded to the signal generator or exported to a new waveform. You need to pay attention that this calibration method requires the VSA software with valid license here. Channel correction has significant impacts on the measurement results of wide bandwidth signal generation. As shown in diagram here, the generated response filter file applied to the waveform improves EVM significantly from 5.33% to 1.356%. So, how does it work? Let's see a demo of how to use this PWSG AWU closed-loop calibration with VSA. Before we start the demo, we need to set up the calibration system at first. There are three main parts as shown here. The yellow area is for the signal generation. The blue area is for the signal analysis. The black area is for the desktop software on PC. First, the signal generator AWG is connected to the signal analyzer via the RF cables. If you have the DUT, then you can connect your DUT between instruments. Here's for the demo purpose, so I just connect them directly. Then on your PC, you can use PathWave signal generation desktop software to make live LAN connection to the signal generator here, and use VSA desktop software to make LAN connection to the signal analyzer. In order to do closed-loop calibration, you may need valid license for both software. After successful configuration of hardware connection and calibration settings, the waveform with channel correction filter files can be downloaded to the signal generator as shown in the red arrow part here. Now, let's look at how to get that done. In PWSG software, let's switch into AWU application by clicking the Advanced Waveform Utility button here. In AWU application, press the hardware button on top bar to config hardware connection at first. AWU supports different types of signal generator. Let's pick arbitrary waveform generator. Then the AWG subpage displays. Then we press it. In address menu, let's type in or select the IP address of instrument we want. There are several settings of instrument you can config here. Let's modify the center frequency to 12 GHz. Press connect button. After a few seconds, I can see that I have a status of connected in the bottom of the window here. To actually config the signal waveform, let's switch into waveform page. It supports various waveform types here. Let's select user-defined format CSV file here. Then in the file name, select the signal we prepared before. As we know, the signal is 1 GHz bandwidth with oversample ratio 32. So let's modify the sample ratio to the 32 GHz. After the configuration, the OSR for the AWG will be automatically modified to 2. Then press the download button. Wait for a few seconds. The waveform will be downloaded to the AWG to playback. Now let's switch to VSA for the analyzer configuration. The first thing we want to do is to make sure that our hardware is connected to Keysight Connection Expert. In this example, I have already established a connection with an N9048B UXA analyzer. So you can see that I have connected through the IP address. For more information and the detailed instruction on how to get your instruments connected properly in the Keysight Connection Expert, please check out our Connectivity in I/O Libraries demo video. So now that I have already established that this connection is good, so we can now go back to the VSA software and try to establish a connection. To do that, click Utilities here at the top, then Hardware, Discovered Instruments. And in this list, you will see that we have found our Keysight N9042B signal analyzer successfully. So go back to the Configurations tab, click the plus icon here. It knows that there are several entries here under the analyzer menu. Here, the Keysight X-Series signal analyzer is the analyzer that I just added. So let's go ahead and establish a connection to that analyzer. What I do is click the title here under the analyzer header. Click this right arrow, and you will see that a new drop-down menu has appeared in this list. If there were multiple X-Series analyzers, there would be several entries in this list I could select from. So in this case, I'm only connected to one UXA analyzer, so there's only one option for me to select. This one is good, so I will go ahead and keep the name as Analyzer 2. Click OK. Now, we still not yet made a connection to the analyzer. As we can see, we are in Analyzer 1. This is for the simulation mode. So we need to click on Analyzer 2. And now you can see it is acquiring the Analyzer 2. Once it is finished establishing a connection, you can confirm by going to a new menu, which we'll see in a moment. And now our instrument is connected. Now let's record the demodulation setup file we prepared before. Press OK. And you can see the signal is demodulated correctly. 60 QAM as we expected. The center frequency is 12 GHz with 1 GHz bandwidth. The EVM is not good enough in this case with 5.3%. Next, let's see how the calibration optimizes this performance. Let's go back to the PathWave signal generation software, press calibration button in calibration window. Because we have already launched the VSA, so keep default setting current here. Then we need to modify the calibration bandwidth to 1 GHz and oversaturation to 2. Waiting time for equalizer convergence 1 second looks good to me, so keep it. Then press calibration button. The calibration of channel correction will automatically start. It may take some time. Once it has completed, you can see a message pops up at bottom bar, says calibration completed, EVM before equalization 5.038%, EVM after equalization is 1.216%. Meanwhile, you can see the constellation diagram and EVM in VSA improves as well. So as we know, this calibration generates the channel correction file by VSA and saved in local C drive under temp folder. So you can apply this correction filter file to the same frequency and bandwidth signal next time for the better performance. PWSG AWU supports or exports a user-defined file with correction filter file to a new waveform file. So press File button, select Export Waveform, type file name and press Save. Then you can import this exported new waveform file. So this time we select the waveform type as Keysight Signal Studio format and select the file we saved before. Press download for the signal generator to playback. We can see that in the VSA now, the new exported waveform is demodulated correctly. Constellation diagram is clean and with better EVM performance, 1.4% here. In summary, PWSG AWU gives you flexibility and good quality in signal generation. It supports several waveform types such as Keysight Signal Studio Waveform, user-defined waveform like CSV or MATLAB file. And all these waveforms can be exported with correction file to a new waveform, which can be downloaded to specified signal generator to playback. What's more, with closed-loop calibration method, you can get better performance, especially for wideband signal measurements. We are constantly working to update and enhance the software. To learn more and to download a free trial, visit us at this website. Thanks for watching.